Our next inductee is Charles Kegley, and he was nominated by Jackie Kegley, so.
All these tall people. My husband was 6'6", so I... Charles came here as one of the founding faculty of this university. He was very excited. We came from New York City. My daughter was merely 3 months old, and we came here. My young son was born here. And he devoted himself enthusiastically to the founding of this university. He was an outstanding teacher. I still meet people in the grocery store who come up to me and say, "Oh, you're Jacqueline Kegley. I had Charles as a teacher. I never forgot him. He was wonderful." And I'd hear all these stories. He was a person who was so concerned about not only students, about every person he met. He listened, he respected every person, and he was admired by every person. He received a number of teaching awards, including the Outstanding Professor here at the university, the CSU Outstanding Professor, and he loved teaching. The story I remember about his concern for students is told by our alumni trustee, John Nylon. John Nylon was a student here, and I guess he wasn't doing too well, and he had missed an exam in Charles's class. Charles, after the class was over, went to the dormitory and looked up John Nylon, and he said, "Get up. You've got to come and take this test." And John never forgot that. He said he was concerned about him, and that inspired him to keep going as a student. He was also very instrumental in helping a number of foreign students. We were in the Philippines. He was a visiting Rockefeller professor in the Philippines. He spent a lot of time and effort helping those students to come to the United States to study. He also sponsored a number of international students, and he did a number of study abroad tours with students, so he was very concerned about broadening their education. He was, in addition to being a teacher, of course, a very fine researcher. He was the founder of the Library of Living Theology, which is one of the well-known books on all of the famous theologians, Reinhold Niebuhr, Paul Tillich, Rudolf Bultmann, and so on, and he published 10 books of his own, and well over 100 articles. So he was an inspired scholar. But he was also a person very concerned, as probably you know, about the ethical life of the community. He was a public philosopher, and for 10 years he ran a talk, I called it a talk show, but he got conned a number of faculty who were scared to death of being on television to come on television for a talk show to talk about burning issues in the community. And so a number of faculty members here at the university participated in that program. He was very concerned about raising the consciousness of the community in terms of ethical and other kinds of issues. He also was a scholar teacher, and he inspired his own family. His twin sons both have PhDs. One has a PhD in political inner science, international relations, well known in the field. His other son has a PhD in psychology. Our daughter went to law school and is now legal counsel at the Wyoming Naval Base. And representing our family today is my son, Stephen, who is an IT at the community college. And a fellow graduate of this university. He has a business degree and a computer science degree. So Charles promoted study abroad, he promoted ethics, he promoted teaching, he was concerned about people. And one of his most famous quotations is, "Inspired by love and guided by reason." And that's the kind of life he led. And I think he had a profound influence not only on this university, but the many, many students, I still hear from them, that he taught. And of course, he inspired our family to go into education. So thank you for honoring Charles, and I'm very pleased that he is being part of this.